practicing the Thais meditation for sound and continuous bowing, just have this very smooth and modulating lines sometimes, piano sometimes, mezzo forte sometimes, fortissimo, and I've actually practiced this while looking into the video recorder. It was not running, but I could see myself like in a mirror, because I don't have a mirror anywhere where I can reasonably practice. So that was, I think, good. Interesting to get this feedback. I still feel that I'm getting into the way of these lines I want to create by moving, maybe not too much, but moving in the wrong way, like, I don't know, doing these kind of things in thought rather than kind of trying to grow from within. That's the way I like to picture it. I mean, it's one of the things that my Alexander teacher tries to make me aware of, and I still don't have developed this inner sense for it, but I have the vision. Well, one of the ideas is that the body will figure it out, right? So, yeah, mostly trying to stay aware, to stay away from this process, or no, to stay out of the way. That's the right way to say it, I think. To stay out of the way, so that this process can work. I also looked at my violin and I noticed that it was kind of slipping away from me, like going into this direction, and then I have to kind of hang on for dear life. So I've used the shelf of my sweater to I'm building a shelf here. My sweater, so that there's kind of a natural place for my violin. Also, it's better that I have my jaw in the chin rest. So this actually feels good, and also secure, but it's a little bit unstable, so it can easily slip away, and then I find it hard to get it back anyway. So also now my hand position has changed a little bit, but I had the feeling that I can work around it without too many intonation problems. I'm still thinking of this vibrato to match the bowing, and I haven't done any exercises, but hope that having the intention of a kind of relaxed oscillation will do its magic. So, I also, I'm not completely secure in playing this by heart, but doing it anyway, and if I have to look something up, that doesn't matter too much at this point, because I feel that I can watch myself better and notice things that if I look into the sheet music, I will not see. The beginning is okay, it can begin soft and also without much vibrato to hear, but then it should kind of blow up, what do you say, like a flower, a bloom, what do you say, should so the German word would be aufblühen, but it cannot be blow up. It's completely different. So that's a Germanism. I have to look it up. This word, if a flower starts to grow. I see. Flower head unfolds, those kind of things. A more airy sound, like a fast and light bow, and then the triad, it has the wrong emphasis at the beginning. I think the transition between these two phrases was, I want to do that again, but I think the first repetition of the phrase had some nice ebb and flow, the way I envision it. didn't feel so bad, but I think it was getting further away from me the longer I played, so I better start with the good position. Also, I'm arcing my back. So I want to be more aware of the space. Space between my vertebrae and at the top of the spine, between the top of the spine and my head, and then my shoulders. I'm thinking of this being a speck in the universe with equal distance all around me. I like that image. Something is not aligned well. Okay, I think that's okay. So it's not perfect correspondence between jaw and chin rest, but feels okay now. Can I get my back? The thing is, when I wonder about ease, I notice ease in my thinking. In my breath, perhaps, not so much in my muscles. A bloom is a word, not blow up. The flower blooms. Yes, it didn't bloom as I wanted it to. But again, I was tense in my bowel arm. Thank you. tune. Watching that, if you do. Thank you. It's been a pleasure to talk. Maybe nobody, or to you, with me. It's actually fun. So, bye-bye.